This one is your pastor has a right to relationship. Now, for those of you that are visiting, let me just tell you, if you don't know, I'm a widower, and was married 11 wonderful years to a beautiful woman. God blessed me with a gift, and whew, awesome. So what I'm getting ready to say, it's really personal because I'm in a new season in my life, and in this season, I need to set this house in order so people know that it's important for them to release their pastor to relationship. Now, I ain't in relationship. You know, ain't nothing happening. I ain't finna drop no bomb on you. I ain't. So if you came, thought you about to hear me say I'm about to marry somebody, the devil is alive now, because I ain't happening right now. I'm reconnecting. I'm healing. I'm working on me. All right? But what's important to understand, I think people have to understand, y'all, is that you have a young pastor. And I'm a young man. And so one day God will speak to me. And people have to learn that I don't belong to them. Like, I think he should. Well, I think he should. Well, I think our next first lady ought to be like you got to live with him. If you really love your pastor, you should be happy about who makes him happy and just be happy. Now, let me say this because it is important for you to receive this in the spirit to which I'm about to give it. Tell your neighbor, he's setting the house in order. Yeah, I'm a young man, and my goal in this season is to walk in integrity. Now, I'm not perfect. I'm a young man, and I want to walk in integrity. I want to lead the people of God. I don't want to bring embarrassment to the kingdom. And in doing that, you have to understand that if I have taught on the matchmaker, before you say I do, this is how to love me. You've heard all this sermon. You've heard all these sermons. Love, relationship, and marriage. You've heard all this. If I have taught on all that to you, don't you think I know a little bit about relationship? So the Bible says, it's a good thing if a man finds a wife. So let me just help some folk. Now, my mama said that if you turn out the lights and you throw a rock into a bunch of dogs, the very dog you hit gonna bark. So if you don't act like you've been hit, nobody won't know I'm talking about you. So you better get ready to play this one off. But I gotta tell the truth. Y'all, listen. I just have an announcement. If I haven't stepped to you, it ain't gonna happen. It's not going, give it up. Stop writing me letters, stop sending me whatnots. God can't be talking to that many women at the same time about one thing. I'm free now. I'm free now. I'm free. I'm free. Now see, because see, you're making yourself look foolish. No, you thinking, because if you sit in my face, you think that it's going to give you some brownie points. I ain't paying you no attention. I'm focused on this word. I'm trying to get the word of God to people. So let me make it one more time. Look at your neighbor and tell them, if he have not stepped to you yet, it ain't going to happen. My single pastor friends told me, they said, Bishop, they said, you know, the unfortunate thing about where you are is that when you do, because, you know, I don't, the dating thing, I believe in courtship. So when you do, when the Lord does send you somebody, that's going to be a great exodus out of your church of women who are going to be upset. And so I just felt like telling you today so you wouldn't waste years. So if you're here for the word and the anointing on my life, then you're in the right place. If you're here for something else, I can't